Rooster and the Till. Yes, got some love for Rooster and the Till in the house. Chefs Rosa Romero and Daniel Figueredo at Sandwich de Miami and their teams. Michelin would also like to give a special thank you to our presenting partner, Capital One. We have our VP, Lauren Liss, here tonight. Where's my girl? Lauren Liss is in the house. Thank you, Capital One. Many thanks to her and to Capital One for supporting the Michelin Guide across the United States. And thank you also to our official partners, Remy Martin, Wine Access, Caviar Food Delivery, Blancpain. Additionally, Michelin would like to recognize preferred partners San Pellegrino, yes, Gaggenau, Nordis Gin, Petrosian. Where's my caviar station at? I'm hitting it hard tonight. There we go. Sergey Kristoff, I see you. Cinco Hotas, Otherland Society Rum, and Delta Airlines. Yes. And now I would like to welcome to the stage Visit Florida President and CEO Dana Young. Hello, everyone. We're going to wait for this awesome video, and then we're going to talk about why we're here. Is anybody excited about being here tonight? Wait till this video ends, but there's no sound, so you know what? We're gonna start. Watch the video, and we're gonna talk because we cannot wait another second to talk about how awesome it is that the Michelin Guide is in Florida. We are here not only to celebrate Michelin coming to Florida and all the everything that means, and it's a lot. But we want to celebrate chefs, chefs that are here, chefs that are going to be honored, chefs that are dishwashers right now and hoping one day to have that honor. We want to honor our restaurant industry, and we want to honor the entire hospitality and tourism industry in the state of Florida. So let's give them a hand. So Florida is quite well known for our incredible beaches, obviously, because they're amazing, and our iconic theme parks, which we were at Universal last night. We've been at Disney earlier. And I mean, Orlando is known for this, and Florida is known for this. But how many of you live in Florida? Raise your hand. Okay, how many of you know that Florida has amazing food? But somehow that has been lost in translation among, you know, people in America and among people around the world. So we are about to change that because we are home to world-class cuisine that is on par with New York, Tokyo, London, Paris, and everyone is about to know it. Food here is such an integral part of the way we live. Like, we live with fresh seafood, we live with fresh produce. We know what it means to have farm and sea to table without giving it that label, right? We are a true melting pot of cultures. We have restaurants that reflect our people, our traditions, our heritage, and they make up what I like to call the many flavors of Florida. For instance, let's talk about our partners here. So you should just know right off, our partners, and I'm gonna introduce them twice. I'm gonna introduce them now, and then I'm gonna introduce them in a minute. So our partners are Orlando, Cassandra Monte, Miami, David Whitaker, and Tampa, Santiago Carrada. You'll see them all in a minute. They're just sitting down up here, but I felt that was important. So, for instance, Orlando has more than 40 different international cuisines across its various neighborhood districts, including Brazilian, Ethiopian, Turkish, and Laotian cuisine. And I don't know if I said that right, but I would like to go there. So, Tampa,
It's my home, but I am not partial. Tampa is home to the oldest restaurant in Florida, the oldest Spanish restaurant in the United States, the Columbia Restaurant, located in Ybor City, Tampa's Latin Quarter. So go Richard Gonsmart if you're here. I don't know if you're here. If you are, I just want you to make your way here, and I'm going to give you a hug. Miami. Miami plays host. I mean, okay, Miami. It's big, right? But it has year-round prestigious wine and food events. The most notably, the Food Network South Beach Wine and Food Festival, the largest wine and food festival in the country, celebrating the vibrant, amazingly diverse destination that is Miami. These are just a few of the reasons why the Michelin Guide approached us and wanted to come to Florida, and we are just so excited to have them here. This is just the beginning, tonight, the beginning of the transformation that will turn Florida into not just a great destination for family travel and beaches and theme parks and nature, but a destination where travelers come specifically to dine and enjoy the gastronomy and the drinks and enjoy the culinary magic that is our state. So cheers to you all out there, really. I can feel the excitement in this room. There's been such a long time, historic connection between food and travel. And I'm gonna give you a couple numbers, even though I'm gonna make it quick. 77% of leisure travelers say that food and drink experiences make them more likely to return to a destination. According to an Ernst & Young study, the Michelin Guide in cities has increased visitor spending, stays, jobs, and the overall quality of their culinary offerings. Apparently, I'm hearing that if you have a city where there is a Michelin star available, that famous chefs from around the world and around the country move to that city so they have an opportunity to get a star. Is that right? Yes, it's apparently right. So we are so proud of our culinary offerings here in Florida, and we're looking forward to being and to growing that Florida vacation brand with the Michelin Guide and our partners. I'd like to recognize those people that I introduced you earlier. I'm gonna ask them to come on stage from our partners that will be featured, or that have sponsored this project for the restaurants that will be featured in the Michelin Guide. So first of all, my partner in crime, because she's the other woman in this group, Cassandra Mate, the Texas Tornado, now with Visit Orlando, President and CEO of Visit Orlando, Cassandra Mate. Next but not least, second but not least, David Whitaker, President and CEO of the Greater Miami Convention and Visitors Bureau. And my dear friend and hometown partner with the Flowing Locks, Santiago Carrada, CEO of Visit Tampa Bay. Come on. Absolutely. So thank you all again for being with us tonight and helping us position the Sunshine State as the number one food destination in the world. Nia's about to come back, and we are on our way to finding out those selections. So thank you all so much.
Thank you. Give them a round of applause. That's okay. First of all, I love Dana's pants, and I love Santiago's boots. So there's that. The fashion here is out of control. Fashion week in Orlando, maybe? I don't know. Let's discuss. Thank you all for making this happen. Now I would like to welcome on stage Michelin North America's president and CEO, Alexi Garcin.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. It's going to be difficult to talk after Nia and Dana, but I have to tell you it's a pleasure to be with you tonight in Orlando, in Florida, in the Sunshine State. And to your point, Dana, I had the pleasure last week to spend some days off in Florida, in Miami. And I can just confirm the beautiful sceneries, the good vibes, and the food. That is quite exceptional.
That is the reason why we gather all together tonight. And you have to know, and I think you know that for Michelin, it is a big deal.
It is a great event, a great news for us to finally have the Michelin Red Guide present in Florida. Yeah. So let me address maybe one elephant in the room for all of us tonight. It may come as a surprise for some of you that the Michelin man that puts tires on your cars, and I hope you all drive on the safest tires on this planet, is the same Michelin man that puts stars on a restaurant. And yes, it is true. And you might ask yourself, why is that? And now, to do that, we have to come back to the end of the 19th century, where the two brothers, André and Édouard Michelin, founded that tire company in Clermont-Ferrand. And their reasoning was very simple for launching the guides. Actually, it was a brilliant marketing recipe. They knew that the more drivers will hit the road with their cars, the more they will need tires, and then the more they will be able to sell tires. So the years after they started the tire business, they produced a small red booklet in 1900 as a travel companion for people out exploring the world in their brand new cars. And so was born the first Michelin Red Guide. But at that time, among other features, including it shows the place to find gas, but also food and lodging. And as these red guys were expanding and gaining in popularity, they then introduced the famous Michelin stars in 1926. And that small red booklet has become all that the Michelin Guide is today, meaning an absolute reference in terms of cuisine excellence and culinary experience. And you all know exactly what I mean here tonight. So I'd like to say that before the Michelin Red Guide, the drive was the journey. Now, with the guide, the dining and the lodging is the journey. Another point for you tonight is that at Michelin, we care about giving people a better way forward. And we do this with tires, around tires and beyond tires. And let me give you a quick illustration of that for all of you, because I think it will resonate with your trip to Orlando tonight. So, if you arrive by plane, it is very likely that Michelin helped this plane to land safely. If you drove down to us tonight, I guess again it has been with Michelin tires. The food that you will eat might have been harvested by machines on our agricultural tires, or delivered by trucks using our commercial tires and fleet services. And I wish that a few of you we'll visit a new Michelin brand starred restaurant before your trip ends. So all of that to say that at Michelin we are dedicated to enhancing mobility for all, as we believe that mobility is essential for us as human. But we also believe that this mobility has to be sustainable. This is why we increasingly use biosourced and regenerated materials in the production of our tires. And it will allow us to turn common waste items, things like corn husks, believe it or not, we use corn husks to produce tires, waste wood and plastic containers into tires and other new products. And our goal is to be carbon neutral in all areas of our business in 2050. And we also apply this sustainable approach to our guide, where we recognize those who combine culinary excellence with outstanding eco-friendly commitments. So you see, Michelin wants to improve every aspect of your journey, seeking the solution of a better tomorrow while operating responsibly today. And this is what we mean by giving people a better way forward. So enjoy this evening and stay tuned for the revelation that comes soon now. Thank you.
Merci, Alexis. Now, it is my pleasure to introduce the International Director of the Michelin Guides and my new best friend, Gwendal Polinek.
But thank you, Alexis. Thank you, Mia, my nouvelle très bonne amie. So my new best friend, and many thanks to you, Dana, to visit Florida, visit Tampa Bay, visit Orlando, and visit Miami. Wonderful teams. So thank you again for having us tonight. Good evening, Florida.
It is so exciting to be present for such an event. This is the first ever Michelin Guide Florida selection. It's the first one, y'all. The very first one. You were here. You could say you were here. So how? I feel amazing. How are you feeling?
Tell me
about you.
Now, what a pleasure to be all together to experience what I believe is an historical moment for both Florida and the Michelin Guide. The official introduction of Florida within the Michelin Guide family. So, we are so excited, as you say, Diana, to let the world know just how special the culinary scenes are in Miami, Orlando, and Tampa.
Yes, and obviously, we cannot wait to discover all these restaurants. Now, these have been selected by your very anonymously famous inspectors. Now, how do they work?
Or internationally and famously inspectors, consisting of men and women from more than 15 different nationalities, are passionate professionals, sharing new love for great food and spending all their time, lunch and dinner, to find out the best places to eat. In the field, our inspector behave just like any other regular guest. They pay their bill, and they never come twice to the same place. Their decisions are never one-man show. Their decisions are team decisions to ensure that ultimately, our recommendations have the same value all around the world.
Well, that sounds amazing. It sounds like the perfect job. In fact, I'm after this gig, I'm actually looking for the next gig. So I'll send you my CV. All it says is I love to eat, but you know.
No, I would say after this evening, you may be a little bit too famous for the chefs here to be able to
That's
be
true.
A famous unanimous inspector.
That's true. Everyone will know who I am now. Not really. All right, so while we wait for the reveal, so maybe you can share with us some of the Florida flavors from your inspectors. Give us a little taste, if you will.
Yes, maybe as an appetizer. What I can share with you is our inspectors were quite impressed and found here that the cuisine were very diverse, satisfying, innovating, and most of all, delicious. So I am pleased to reveal that the very first selection includes 118 total restaurants and features more than 35 different types of cuisine.
Wow, that's amazing. 118 restaurants, 35 different cuisines. Truly, truly a global brand. So thank you very much for that. Now, before revealing the actual selection, we'd like to start with some special recognition, special Michelin awards. Wendell, can you tell us more about these?
Yeah, but maybe before moving to the award, I just would like to remind you that, as you may know, the Michelin Guide was born 120 years ago. But since then, we didn't change the way we work. You know, the inspectors are fiercely anonymous, and they award the restaurants only based on the quality of the food, following five universal criteria. The quality of the product, the mastery of cooking techniques, the balance and harmony in flavor, the personality of the cuisine, you know, as expressed on the plate, the identity of the chef and his team, and also the consistency, both over time, and throughout the menu as a whole. So with this methodology, we can ensure that one star in Tokyo is worth one star in Paris or here in Florida.
Absolutely. All right, so what do we have coming up next here? A very important award, yes?
Yes, as you may know, our culinary distinctions go to restaurant as a whole. It's about
teamwork. We reward the quality of the teamwork. But this special award, the Michelin Guides, with this special award, the Michelin Guides want to highlight the diversity of the job that are making the restaurant industry today. Why also honoring high-level individuals who make a restaurant experience unique and unforgettable. So, why enjoying good food? We often like to pair it with a wonderful wine. And the sommelier is definitely part of the taster journey, and that's why we created the Sommelier Award.
Yes, and to present the award, we would like to welcome Joe Fish, CEO of Wine Access. Where's Joe?
Nia, Wendell, thank you so much. It's an absolute pleasure to partner with the Michelin Guide and recognize Florida for the superb culinary scene that you all have built. It's my first time back in Orlando in about 10 years, and I was absolutely blown away with the growth of the city. I love the countless sights and attractions the city has to offer, but I've always had an affinity for Epcot, for what it represents in pushing the boundaries of what humans can do. And when I thought about the park's original concept around innovation and international culture, it felt so suiting when I started to think about the food and wine scenes in Tampa, Miami, and Orlando. One of my favorite things in the world is to geek out reading through wine lists to understand the story it tells. And like any great story, it needs an author, or beverage director in this case, which is obviously why I'm here, to present Sommelier of the Year. And with that distinct pleasure, please join me in congratulating Victoria James of Cote as your Sommelier of the Year. Unfortunately, Victoria could not be here, so accepting the award on Victoria's behalf is Simon Kim, owner of Coke.
Well, clearly I'm not Victoria James. Victoria is not here today. She's in New York, so I'm accepting the award from her. Michelin Guide, obviously, is the world's most respected and credited restaurant guide in the world with a great prestige. And to receive this honor on the most important day, the inaugural launch of Michelin Guide, is such an honor. I'm deeply grateful, and thank you very much.
Thank you.
And to the quality team, you know, they definitely make the difference, anticipating the guest expectations. And they have a key role in enhancing the whole dining experience.
Yes, congratulations. That's amazing. Now next up is what I think is going to be my favorite award, the Exceptional Cocktails Award. Sounds like some of you have already made that happen for yourselves. Back there, getting a little rowdy. We like it, sort of. All right, now Michelin strives to recognize all aspects of the culinary experience, including honoring those who create unique, top-quality cocktails.
And the award goes to... Reuben Roland and the team... Reuben Roland and the team Le Jardinier et l'Atelier de Joël Robuchon, Miami.
Yes, give it up for Reuben. Reuben, you gotta make me a cocktail later, okay? Since you won that award, I wanna taste it for myself. Okay, now that was an amazing way to start, Wendell. I think it's time to discover the restaurants awarded by the Michelin Guide for the first time in Florida. I can't get over, this is the first time. Again, You guys are not getting hyped enough about this. This is the first time Michelin is in Florida. The Sunshine State? Yes. Yes. Okay. Could you imagine if that wasn't it? All right, but before we start, can you tell us what the Michelin Guide selection means?
Yeah, absolutely, Nia. So the Michelin Guide selection recognizes the best restaurants. So regardless of the style of their cooking, from luxury restaurants to local casual eateries, these restaurants are considered as the best in their country, the best in their destination. So therefore, being part of our selection means a lot and is a great accomplishment. And I would like to remind you that this year, 118 restaurants made it.
Yes, thank you. Wendell, the Michelin Guide is particularly known for its stars, but there are other distinctions such as the Bib Gourmand, right? I actually had not heard of it until recently. Tell us about the Bib Gourmand.
Yes, absolutely. So the Bib Gourmand distinctions highlights the restaurants offering exceptional quality and value for money. So in these places, in these restaurants, you can have a full meal, two meal, or two quarts and a good one glass of wine for less than $50.
Yep, we love that. We love a bargain. We love a deal. We like a bang for our buck. It's very promising. All right, well, if we're ready, we're gonna reveal the first selection of Bib Gourmand restaurants. This is a very big deal. Let's make sure everyone is quiet so everyone can get their recognition.
Restaurant Bachour! More to go.
It's not over.
Rooster and the Hill. Sandwich de Miami. Strand. Swan and Sons.
All right.
The Ravenous Pig.
Swan and Sons.
All right. And our next final grouping. Tinta y Café, Z Asian, Zach the Baker, Zitz Sum. All right, let's give it up for our first ever Bib Gourmand. recipients in Florida.
So in total, 29 Bib Gourmand over the three cities.
Congratulations. Amazing. See, this is what I love about being part of this awards. These are real, creative, passionate people getting recognized for what they do. I find it so inspiring. I love it. Okay. Are we ready?
Okay.
Are we ready? Because we're about to do a big reveal, all right? This is the moment you've all been waiting for. The first Michelin-starred restaurants in Florida, okay? The Michelin star is iconic for fine dining lovers and, of course, such an achievement for the professionals.
So the star highlights the gastronomic excellency in the destinations. Getting a star means that only your restaurant is one of the best in the city, but one of the best in your country, and one of the best in the world.
All right, now when your name is called, please come up to receive your jacket. We know it's hot, but you gotta put it on. You're getting a Michelin star, okay? Rock with it, roll with it.
So are you ready?
Yes, come get your jacket and be on
stage. So we are pleased to welcome to the 2022 selection of the Michelin Guide in Florida with one star from Restaurant Ahmed.
Get up here, Michael Beltran. This is your moment. Where are you? Where is he? Here he is. Yes. Yes. All right, Michael's getting his jacket on. Okay, Michael Beltran with the corn rolls.
Congratulations,
okay. Michael. Okay. All right. I love it. Tell me who got your hair. I need to know. It looks very fresh. Okay, up next. Our next reveal.
Restaurant Boyardee.
Boyardee is in the house. Oh my God, this is so much fun. This is really amazing. I want to get drunk with all of you tonight. This is how exciting and fun this is. Yes, looking good, looking sharp. Come on, let's go. Get up here. That's awesome. All right.
And we continue. Restroom. Top off.
Chef, Gabriel, massive, Chef Gabriel. Yes, congratulations, Gabriel. Chef.
Gabriel. Okay, next one. Todd Smiley. More to go.
Jardinier,
Miley!
Seth Blumenthal, if you can report to the stage. Chef Alain. There we go.
Let's continue. So thank you. And we have a last addition for the one star. The surf from Russia. All together for a group picture. So maybe you can stay with us.
All right. One more time, a round of applause. Florida is hyped tonight. I am feeling the energy that
Florida. Orlando!
Let me hear it. All right. So. All right, well, I guess that wraps it up then. I guess we're good. I guess we can start drinking.
Yes. Yes, because we are not over yet.
Not done yet. It's not over yet.
No, because we have
we're still going.
A great news, because we still have 2 stars to award to a restaurant.
Yes, 2 stars. 2 stars.
And 2 stars goes to So I sincerely hope that this selection will encourage gourmets from all around the world to discover or travel to Florida.
Thank you, Wendell, and again, a huge, huge congratulations to all the chefs, the restaurant, the team, the hostess, the waiters, the bartenders.
So, and I think it's time to raise a glass to all these world-class chefs and their teams.
On stage.